Hello, welcome. I will start with an example. That example is our the spacer tank system, and we will develop the fault tree for this system. Already we have seen it, and then with reference to fault that pressure tank system, there are different basic events. So, what is the contribution of the basic events in realizing the top event for a fault tree? So, by importance measures, we want to say that given a fault tree, there will definitely be several basic events. And you can develop several cut set also. By cut set we mean that there is a set of the basic events which, if occur, the top event will occur. Now let us know that the top event the contribution of basic events to top events means, if there are suppose k number of basic events, so you may be interested to know which of these basic events is having the maximum contribution in realizing the top event, or which of the cut sets having the maximum contribution in realizing the basic events. So, this is basically talks about the importance. So, what will happen if we know the importance? We will take necessary care, and it also gives us the opportunity to rank the basic events in terms of occurrence of the top event. And then you will take necessary action according to the rank of their contribution. So, that means the one which is contributing the maximum for the top event to occur, you put barrier so that that failure will not take place. So, the importance measures as such, the fault tree development also, it is manually intractable. What do I mean that manually cumbersome? So, when you have a system which is sufficiently large enough and you must rely on some software for developing the fault tree. So, RAM Commander is one such software which basically helps in developing fault tree and analyzing the fault tree in terms of finding out the top event probability given the bottom event probability, finding out the importance measure, finding out cut set, so that RAM Commander can be used. So, we will show you that with reference to this pressure tank system, so that the result obtained using fault tree, and through RAM Commander. So, by saying this, we are not saying that the RAM Commander is the solution to fault tree analysis only, because there are many softwares available which can be used, but we have RAM Commander, we have used this one. So, let us see one after another. So, this I should not discuss further, because I have discussed it several times that this is our example. And I also said to you all that we have taken this example from the book written by Komamoto and Henle, Probabilistic Risk Assessment for Engineer and Scientists. So, if you purchase this book, or if you have access to this book, then definitely what will happen, the many of the tools and techniques and the concept what I am teaching to you, you will revisit all those things to in the book, and ultimately your understanding will be more clear. But I will try my level best to clarify the things, and I hope that if you go through some standard literature, not necessarily the same book, but standard literature on it, and then it will be beneficial to you. So as you know that there is a tank and your pumping system, so we want to, suppose we are interested to know the fault tree analysis of this system, where the top event is tank rupture. Okay. So you see, that is what we have developed here, and I have taken this from this book. It is already developed there. So pressure tank rupture, this is the system level mishap or accident. You don't want this rupture to take place. So as a result, you want to know what are the reasons of pressure tank rupture, and what are the basic events that alone or in combination contributing to the pressure tank rupture. So first one is the pressure tank itself. This is the primary cause. So I have explained to you that PSC concept, primary, secondary and common failure. This, if the suppose the tank itself, because of usage over the year, there can be wear, tear, and there can be corrosion and other issues. So ultimately what will happen, the tank itself may fail even within the desired pressure level, that is for which it is intended. But this is related to the tank itself. Now second one is that there is secondary tank failure. What I told you earlier, that secondary failure, tank failure means something which is basically that some excessive stress and other things which are caused by maybe neighboring component and others, but whose actual region may not be further explored. At this point it is underdeveloped event. So essentially we will be going through by P and C, that is primary and common failure. Now what are the common failure to this? So as you have seen that the timer is set to a particular time, and accordingly the pump will run for that time. So if everything goes well, what will happen, that ultimately that the pump ceases to work after the desired amount of gas fed into the tank, and the pressure in the tank will be within the design intent. But it may not happen. So that means it may happen that you fed more, and because of many reasons, that is what is basically common. So if there is common failure, then overpressure to tank will occur. Why overpressure to tank will occur? Because pump operates too long. So why pump operates too long? Because current is too long. Now if current is too long, why current is too long? Because contactor closed too long and switch is closed too long. So when contacts are closed too long, that primary contacts failure, then no command to open contact, and then secondary failure. So in using PSC concept, we have found out the final fault tree. The fault tree, what happened, what are the basic event? Basic event B1 is primary tank failure. Basic event B2 is primary contact failure. Basic event B3 is primary timer failure. Then event B4 is primary switch failure. Then event B5, operator failure. B6, alarm failure. So as this I have discussed earlier also. So now if we ignore the secondary failures, because we are not in a position to know what is the probability of these as well as this, as well as this, 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 and this. I am putting zero because we don't know that thing. So for the time being, okay, their probability will be definitely very small, almost near about zero, then you ignore it. Otherwise, if you think no, that some of the secondary issues are there, then you have to brainstorm within the team and then explore it further. That is what is the general procedure. Now, my question here is that I have found that there are six number of basic events. So the basic set is now 6, B1, B2, B3, B4, B5 and B6. So you may be interested to know that which of these contributing maximum for the tank rupture. Or already you have seen the cut sets, how to compute the cut set. So that means which cut set is contributing maximum to the top event to occur. Here we will concentrate on the basic events. Okay. So then what are the importance measures? There are many importance measures, and the importance measures are quantitative measures. What it does, it quantify the contribution of the basic events or the MCS. What is MCS? Minimal cut set, to the occurrence of the top event. You have seen earlier that B1 to B6, so these are the basic events. You want to have a quantitative measure that will tell you what is the contribution of this event in the top event, the tank rupture to occur. That is what we are saying. Why we should do this? Let me explain further. It helps to rank the critical parts and guide in choosing effective actions. Let me go back. What do you see there? What are the critical parts here? Suppose tank is one, contact another one, timer another one, then your price switch, then alarm, so these are the things basically we have considered here. Okay. So now, which one of these, that contact, or your that basically what I mean to say, the switch or alarm or tank, which one is the most critical one? So you may be interested to know this, that which is the critical part, which are the critical parts. So you have to take action against failure of those critical parts. So importance measures are generally time dependent. So their relative ranking is applicable within the mission time. What do I mean by this? That it may so happen that within the set time it will fail. Then in this case it is basically or much before. In particular within this example, we have a set time, that pump time, within this it may fail. So that can be said the mission time. Here in this particular case, maybe the success and failure is important, but there may be situation when you will not preset the time, that how long it will work. You continue working with that system, and accordingly the component also exposed or under operation, and then what will happen, the probability of failure of those components ultimately depend on the time of use. So under such situation, when you talk about the importance measure, then we have to clearly mention the mission time. Let us see that what are those measures available. The major, first major is this Birnbaum Importance Index. What it is given to us? It given that the probability that the system is in a state where a particular component is critical. Okay, suppose the tank, our the pressure tank in the system, so system will be under normal state, under abnormal state, maybe over pressure condition, or maybe the rupture condition, that is tank rupture. So what we mean to say that the system can be in a particular state given a component is critical, means the component may fail. So this means that the if the component fails, the system fail. So system fail here in the sense that system may be under overpressure, since tank rupture has taken place, something like this. So how it is computed? The formula is this, that importance measure for a particular event BI. So BI relates to a particular component. So then this is basically del QS by del QI, where QS is the system level unavailability and QI is the component level unavailability. So the pressure tank system is available or not available. If there are something abnormal takes place, it is unavailable. For example, tank rupture means it is completely unavailable. So now the component, for example, the timer may be unavailable under failed state. So then the rate is del QS by del QI, that is what is basically our Birnbaum importance measures. So what it talks about, it measures the rate at which an increase in component unavailability or unreliability affects the increase in the system unavailability or system unreliability. Okay, so that means if this component fails, what will happen to the system? The rate of increase in component system unavailability depends on the increase in the system component unavailability. You want to know this, then this is basically Birnbaum measure. Now there are so many basic events, so many components. So find out this IBI, and then accordingly you just rank them, which one is having the maximum contribution followed by minimum contribution. So if we use this formula, then we will be able to find out the component level or event, basic event level contribution. And the physical meaning is this. This one has certain problem because it doesn't depend on the unavailability of the component itself. Anyhow, so let us see with an example. Now let us concentrate on this. It's an example without any physical significant meaning I am giving you. What we are saying, that there is a top event, and this top event will take place given one basic event A and another gate, that we are basically saying intermediate gate. So these two are input, and there is an AND gate linked to top event. Now again this intermediate gate, this intermediate gate, that is the OR gate, it has two inputs, event B and event C. So that means how many events are there? There are three basic events. So with reference to this example, we will explain the Birnbaum measure. Fine. So let assume that the probability of this event occur is 0.3, probability of B event occur is 0.2, probability of C event occur is 0.1. Then using gate by gate method or cut set method, ultimately you will be able to find out the probability of the top event is this. What is this? 0.084. How? This will be that A time multiplied by B, this one here B plus C B will be there and C is there, but this gate probability or gate probability you find out using the normal calculation, and then AND gate is there, these two will be multiplied, you will be getting like this, or you can use Cartesian method and you will find out this. So let us go by this example and let's see what is happening. Now what is the system level unavailability? System level unavailability is the system is under fail state. When it will be under fail state? If A failure occur and B failure occur, it will be failed. Similarly, if A and C occur, it will be failed because these two are the minimal cut set for this system. So that means the system will be unable if this as well and this occur. This occur or this occur. So that means the collectively what happened, the union part, this union part, this ultimately lead to talks about the system unavailability. So we have two minimal cut set AB and AC. This with OR gate, any one of them will ultimately lead to system unavailable. So we are denoting by this, and union is denoted by plus here. Now if you use the OR gate symbol, you will find out what is A, what is the unavailability of A, that is QA, which is nothing but 0.3, that is the probability of that event will occur. And then QB, similarly then this for AB, this is fine. For AC, QA into QC, QC because ABC they are independent. And minus, we know that this into this. So AB into A, intersection AB, AA will be A, so it will be ABC, so QA, QB, QC. Okay, so what I mean to say, this P AB plus AC equal to A intersection B plus B intersection C minus that AB intersection AC. So then A and A will be A intersection B intersection C. So if you give probability, here you put probability, so then this one A and B independent, PA into PB, and now PA is the probability that the component A is unavailable, that is QA, PB is component is B component unavailable, that is QB, and probability of C is QC. So in that sense. So this is your system probability level failure probability, it is known. Now we will use this equation. So our equation is QS equal to this. If we take derivative with reference to QA, what will happen? This one will become this, QB only. Derivative of this will be this, and derivative of this will be QB into QC. Now you know QB, QC and QB, its values are known. What is QA? QA is 0.30. What is QB? 0.20. What is QC? 0.10. So if you put the value here, what happened? 0.QB20 plus 0.10 minus 0.20 into 0.1. So that means 0.30 minus 0.02, this result into this quantity. So the Birnbaum importance measure, the basic event A, its contribution is this. If it fails, the top event failure will be something like this. Now if we go by B, then again you take derivative del QS by del B, you will be getting this equation, and you put the values like this, similarly I see like this. So that means importance wise B, A, B, C, 0.28, 0.27, 0.24, almost they are equal kind of things. Okay, with reference to rate of increase in unavailability of the component increases, that with leads to increase in unavailability of the system. That is what we are talking about. Second important measure is your FV, that is Fossil Vessel Importance Index. So Fossil Vessel Importance Index, it measures the probability that component I contributes to the system failure, given that system failure has already occurred. I know that system failure has occurred. So, you want to know what is the contribution of component I. So, general formula is, suppose you have for the system level fault 3, that you have how many card sets? M number of card sets, K1 to KM. And let the CJ is an indicator variable. What does it say? CJ will be 1, equal to 1. If component I belong to MCS KJ. So, you consider a KJ, MCS, which is KJ. Now, in this MCS cut set, whether the component, ith component, that event is there or not, whether it is input that set. If it is yes, then it will be 1, otherwise it will be 0. So, if equal to 1, if component I, so it means I belongs to KJ. So then that measure is like this. So it equal to probability that union of indicator variable times that particular MCS divided by system level unavailability. Now what will happen? Suppose if out of this m number of cut sets, minimal cut sets, suppose only one cut set contain the component, then what will happen? That out of this 1 to m, only 1 is applicable, the jth one. So, this sum, this will be probability of kj by this. Okay. So, let us see with the reference to the example. Now, what is Fossil Vessel Importance? Sum of all MCS containing event I by sum of all MCS. So, this is my system level unavailability, we have seen it. Now, what we will do, that FBA is probability of this by this. Now, what we have required to know, we are interested for A. Now, you see how many cut sets are there, 2 cut sets. So, A included in both cut sets, yes. So, the sum of all MCS containing I, what is this? AB and AC by sum of all MCS, then this probability and this is nothing but QS. So, QS system by Q system, this is 1. Now, if we go by the second one, that is the B, then you see B is in the first cut set, not in the second cut set. So, probability of this by system unavailability value is this. Similarly, C in the second cut set, not in the first set, value is this. So, with reference to this example. So, now what I can say, that if the top event occur, the which one is maximum top failure, that system level failure occur, maximum contribution is given by this, followed by this, followed by this. So, this is your Fossil Vessel Importance. So, there are few more like risk reduction or risk decrease factor. It is defined as the decrease in the risk when the component is assumed to be optimized or made perfectly reliable. Suppose, for example, A. Suppose it will not fail. So, that means the event probability, failure probability will be 0. Or B, it will not fail. Or C, it will not fail. Then what happened, if we can made some of the component should not fail, then originally whatever the failure was there, it will be reduced. So, that risk is reduced, failure risk is reduced. So, then what is the formula here? Sum of all MCS divided by sum of all MCS taking into account that the event I probability is 0. With reference to this example, sum of all MCS is basically probability of this is nothing but Q system. This is this, we know. Now, what we want to do now? We want to find out for reason for A. So, what we have to do? Sum, the numerator will be Q system, What will be the denominator? Denominator will be sum of all MCAs taking into account I, that event probability is 0. That means what I mean to say that QA this will be 0 because you make it perfectly reliable. Now if I put QA 0, it is becoming infinite. In a similar way, if I put QB 0 here, then this is the resultant, and so the value is 2.8. Similarly, if you make component C completely reliable, then it is 1.4. So that means from this measure we found that if you make the A completely reliable, this will not happen because of AND gate is also there, because it requires this as this to occur. But there, for B and C, the value is low, because even if B will not occur, suppose A and C occur, top event will occur, or A, B occur, top event will occur. So as a result, their risk decrease factor is, B and C's risk decrease factor is lower than A. Although infinite is, it is basically a theoretical value, but the physical meaning is that if you make it reliable, because of the AND combination, it will the top event will never occur if you can make it completely reliable. So risk increase factor, that means what happened in the risk decrease factor, what we say, the components are completely reliable. So if a component is completely reliable, what is the reduction if you make reliable? In risk increase factor, suppose one component is always under fail state, so then what is the increase? So that one is sum of all MCAs taking into account the event probability is 1, event I probability is 1, because it is in failed condition or it is not available, by sum of all MCAs. Now sum of all MCAs is nothing but the, we are saying that Q system, unavailability of the system. Then what happened, in the numerator, what you will do, first you make the QA equal to failed, means QA equal to 1. If you make QA equal to 1, then this is this one 1, that means QB, then it is QC minus QB QC by QS, this value is 0.833. In the same manner, B and C values are B 3.57 and C 3.57, these two are same. So what it is saying? That means, actually, it is basically we are saying that if any of the component unavailable or under fail state, what is the risk increase? That means probability of top event that will increase. So because of OR gate, you see that B and C's value. Just what is QA value? QA value is 0.30. What is top event value? 0.084. So okay, it is almost this. Top event value is this. And again, okay, in both cases QA is coming. Why? Suppose QB equal to 1, then QA, this QC, okay, then it is QA and QC, QC, this equal to B equal to 1, QC minus QC, it is QA, part correct. Now if we see C equal to 0, QA, QB, and that this is 1, that this is QA, and QA, QB, okay, this is correct. So this is what is the way you just see that one hand you are getting that rate of increase of the top level failure given the increase in the component level failure, Brigham measure. Then we have come to the Fussell-Wessel measure. What we have discussed in Fussell-Wessel measure? You see, we basically discussed that sum of all MCAs containing event by sum of these. So if the contribution of a particular event, if it is in all the cut states, it has the maximum contribution. And someone which is having in one or more or some of the cut sets, it will be less contribution. So that importance measures giving you like this. Then this is similar to your bring home measure also. But risk reduction decrease factor means you make one component perfectly reliable, and what will happen to the system level failure, and what is the contribution of this towards system level failure, what will happen. And then when another one is basically, suppose one is completely unavailable. So these are the extremes basically we are talking about. But anyhow, there are different measures. These measures will help you to understand the criticality of the parts, and accordingly you can take decisions. Now here we have used RAM Commander, and we have developed this fault tree. And this fault tree can be manually developed also, so that also we have seen. But thing is that we want to see all the that card sets as well as the importance measures from this, because manually computing those importance measures will be difficult, in the sense that may not be possible also. So now see what happened. How many card sets are there? 1 is 4, 5, then 2, 5, 4, 6, 2, 6, 3, 4, 2, 3, like this. So how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 card sets are there. Okay. So that means what will happen? If I want to know the Q system, then definitely you will say 1 plus this 4, 5. So if I say this is cut set 1, that means we are saying that K1. So that means it is K1 plus K2, like this, the union part up to K7. And also you know that they are AND gate. So ultimately probability that 1 plus 4, 5, 4 into 5, like this. And then what you have to do, you have to find out the important measure. So accordingly, in case of bring home, find out the derivative and you go on doing this one, but it is really laborious, cumbersome. So what we will do, we have used this software and we found out the values. Now let us see what are the values. So the values, unavailability for the first one, second one, this 1 to this 6 basic events. And then what happened, that first level measure, and the risk reduction factor and risk increase factor we have computed. Now if I go by this measure, so which one is the maximum? Maximum is this one, followed by this. Okay, it is in order of in decreasing sequence. So this is contributing maximum. When I go for RDF also, but all are zero here. But maybe after some zero, some values will be there. But here if I go risk increase factor, this one 10 to the power 2, okay, that means this is also contributing. Obviously the pressure tank failure is, once it happens, it completely the tank rupture which take place. So it has definitely the maximum importance. So by no time you should allow the wear and tear of the pressure tank to such level that it will happen and this tank rupture will take place. Okay, so that is the most critical component of the system what we have discussed so far. So I hope you have understood the importance measures. So there are references, 3 references are given from where we have taken the resource material, and I hope that you understand the importance of this importance measures. So one is bring home measure, second one is first level measure, third one is risk reduction factor, fourth one is risk increase factor, and these all are basically to find out the importance, relative importance of each or of the cut sets or the basic events. And primarily we have discussed from basic events point of view. And accordingly, if the importance of the basic event or basic event will be ranked in terms of importance when there are huge number of basic events, you can use the Pareto plot, find out these kind of things, and maybe few very important, means 80% of the importance may be from few of the basic events, and definitely you try to make them as reliable as possible, means their availability should be maximum, unavailability should be near to zero. So thank you very much. We'll meet again in the next class.